Glory, glory, glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Yes. Glory, glory, glory.
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. Amen. We thank you for tuning in tonight. Amen. Thank you. Lamar Graves. Amen. Melissa Williams. Gladys Bussey is on tonight. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. I want to send a special shout out to my friend Mary Harrison that's watching. Amen. I heard that she's been watching every week. Amen. Hallelujah. Come on, come on, y'all. Come on. And let us know that you're listening tonight. Let us know that you're ready to receive from the Lord tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. We're happy that you have tuned in. Amen. We don't take it lightly. We don't take it for granted. We just thank God. Amen. For everyone watching tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. All of our partners. All of our family members. Amen. All of our church members. Amen. We just thankful for you. Amen. Hey, Mark Ross. Amen. Thank God for Mark Ross. Amen. All right. Miss Lois Fletcher is on tonight. Hallelujah. Miss Lois, I believe God got a word for you tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Everybody, come on, set us up some hearts. Amen. To let us know, hallelujah, that you appreciate what God is doing and what God is going to do tonight. Amen. Hallelujah. Mary Glover. Amen. That's my sister. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory, glory, glory.
Amen. Deacon Bobby Fletcher is on tonight.
All right.
Miss Angela Clark, good to see you. Dez is on tonight.
Hallelujah.
Gio, we see you. Amen. We're just about to get started. We're almost ready. Amen.
Yeah.
Getting ready to start with faith. Go ahead and share. Amen. Go ahead and share.
Hallelujah.
Share.
Thank you.
Amen. We're having an exciting time tonight.
Yeah.
We are super excited. Amen. We are ready.
Yes. Amen.
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 Brother John is on tonight. Go ahead and share.
Oh, yes.
Amen. Go ahead and share. Glory to God. Hallelujah. I feel it already. My Kissimmee Bussy is on tonight.
All right, my Kissimmee. Amen. Hallelujah.
Better known as Bear Bear. Crash Bar Turner is on tonight.
All right.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Glory to God. Good to see you tonight.
Oh, yeah.
Amen. Good to see you tonight. We're so excited to have you on with us tonight. Amen.
Amen.
We are really excited to have you. We're going to deal with faith. We've been on this faith this whole month. We're going to be dealing with faith.
Amen.
Because faith is so important.
Yes, it
is. In fact, the Bible says in Hebrews 11:6, I believe it is, it says, without faith,
it's impossible
to please God.
Amen.
Faith is extremely important. And faith is one of the most challenging areas to teach and preach in this particular region, because when you're talking about a Bible Belt region like where we're in, it's mainly a traditional and a religious type of region.
Yes.
And faith challenges you to look at things different. When we're talking about a lifestyle of faith.
Yes.
And faith challenges you in a way that most people are not accustomed to being challenged.
That's right.
You know, when we're talking about faith and how people who I've seen come to our ministry, and they come to our ministry, they come from a very religious or traditional background. Mm-hmm. And then they come up on our type of ministry, and it's the kind of ministry that challenges you, it stretches you.
Yes.
And it constantly see more in you than sometimes you see in yourself. And so you start to try to pull on people, and you want to pull them to a place to where you believe they can go. They have
That's
the potential
right.
to go.
Amen.
And sometimes a lot of people don't understand, you know, that kind of stretch or that kind of pull, because you come from an environment where just any old kind of way of do it. But when you talking about faith, and it's not putting anybody down, it's not putting anybody down, but when you're talking about this kind of faith, when God begin to show you the impossible, it's hard to just be ordinary.
All right, that's
it's
right.
hard to think ordinary.
Amen.
I mean, in fact, you literally have to almost go like, I remember my dad used to say to me, I'm about to lose my mind, mm-hmm. or something like that, lose your mind. Well, he was talking about that old mind and
All
taking
right.
on a new mind.
Yeah.
Amen. To
Amen.
Where you think different.
Mm-hmm.
And when we talk about walking with God in faith, it challenges us to think different.
That's right. Amen.
It challenges us. I mean, it literally shifts the way we think.
Yeah.
And this is, if you want to get challenged by it, if you want a real good fight,
yeah.
start dealing with faith.
Come on.
One thing the enemy doesn't want you to do is grab a hold to faith. Because when you grab a hold of faith, hear me now, when you grab a hold of faith, this is what it says. You now put God in his proper place.
All right. That's
because
it.
Now you make God your source.
Yes. Yes.
You solely depend upon God.
Amen.
And the enemy don't want you operating in faith, because a lifestyle of faith means that you're depending upon God every single day for every single need.
That's
you can
good.
Have a job, but your job is not your source. Your job is your resource.
All right. That's it.
And so it's and that's a mindset.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
That's a mindset. So you when you're walking in faith, the enemy challenges you a lot because he don't want you to grab a hold of that word.
That's right.
The Bible says that he come for the sake of the word. And the Bible says that also that faith cometh by hearing,
mm-hmm.
hearing by the
word of God.
The word of God.
Amen.
And so the enemy comes for the sake of the word.
Yes.
He doesn't mind us being in an atmosphere, and I love it, and I'm sure you've experienced it as well, when the atmosphere is so high and we're dancing and we're shouting and we're speaking in tongues, and that's amazing. But the enemy will fight you in a quiet service when word is being taught and faith is being presented.
That's right.
Because that's where you grab a hold of your confidence in God.
Amen.
That's when you shake the fear.
Mm-hmm.
That's when you learn how to trust God at a whole new level.
That's it. That's it.
That's when you can lose your job. And not saying it won't shake you, but you go back to your source.
That's it. Amen.
The same God gave you one job can give you two jobs.
Amen.
You know, so tonight we want to just get deeper in that. I want to talk tonight about relationship and how faith works in relationships.
Hallelujah.
And how it grows your faith, and what literally grows your faith. The power of your relationship,
yes.
and how you relate to people, how you relate to God.
Amen.
And so we want to talk about that tonight. So don't go anywhere, but we're getting ready to pray, but what I need you to do is look down in your left-hand corner if you have an iPhone, and share, hit that share button, share.
Yeah.
Amen. Comment, tell us what city you're in.
Hallelujah.
We definitely want to know what city you're in, and we want to pray for you as well. Amen.
Amen.
Want to pray for your city.
That's
we pray
right.
for you after things are over.
Yeah.
So that's why it's so important. That's why we ask you to comment, especially if you have a need.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
That's
you
right.
ready?
Amen. I'm ready.
Amen.
Amen.
Well, I'm already fired up. I guess I'll go ahead and lead us in prayer.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then. Let's get ready to
Thank
pray.
You,
Are you ready? If you're in a room with someone, can you just reach out and grab
Thank
a hand?
You.
Or if you got some kids running around, if you can just
Thank
quiet
you,
them for a second. And let's just take this moment. We know we're not in the same building, but God is omnipresent.
Yes. Hallelujah.
The same Spirit of the living God that's with me and with us is the same Spirit of the living God that's with you.
Amen.
He's in all places at all times. And so what we want to do, we want to come together in agreement, the
yes.
power of agreement. Let's begin to agree right now that God will begin to speak to both of our hearts tonight, that we can share something tonight that will be encouraging, uplifting, motivating,
yes.
inspirational,
Amen.
And impactful
Hallelujah.
To you. I pray tonight that the heavens be open.
Thank Thank you,
I pray tonight that God be kind unto us.
Yes, Lord.
I pray tonight that he shadow us and overshadow us with fresh revelation.
We receive
I pray
it
tonight that God will give us fresh rhema tonight.
Yes, Lord.
Father, we declare and we decree that the heavens be open. We come tonight against every form of principality, every
yes,
power
Jesus.
Of darkness, every ruler, every spiritual weakness, high place,
yes,
and we come
Lord.
Against you tonight. We take authority
Jesus.
Over the atmosphere.
Yes,
we open
Lord.
Our mouth and
Hallelujah.
Take authority over the atmosphere.
Thank you, Lord.
We declare and decree there be no distractions.
No distractions.
We declare and decree there be no mechanical failures.
Hallelujah.
We declare and decree that no one that listen to this service, though
Thank
they may
you,
be
Lord.
In a car, in their home, on their job, that
yes.
they will leave the same. We pray that the same transforming God that meets them in the sanctuary,
yes.
meets them in the place of their heart where
Hallelujah.
They are right now. Let that place be a sanctuary. In fact, we dedicate it to you, oh God.
Yes.
We dedicate it and consecrate it for you right now in the name of Jesus so you can rest in that place right where they are. We pray for every person who is sick.
Yes,
we pray
Jesus.
For their body to be made whole right now.
Thank
we
you, Lord.
Even visit now the hospitals and every loved one that they have that are suffering in the hospitals right now.
Yes,
we ask that you would go by the room, oh God, and simply sit upon them and heal them in
yes,
the mighty
Lord.
Name of Jesus.
Name
Let
of
your
Jesus.
Fire fall from
your
heaven
fire,
and consume every Glory form of sickness.
Name,
we thank you tonight.
Thank you, Lord.
We bless you tonight.
Hallelujah.
We honor you tonight
thank you, Lord.
Because you're our God.
You're
our Jehovah Jireh.
Yes,
you're our Jehovah Nissi. You're our Lord God, the
yes,
creator
Lord.
Of all things.
Hallelujah.
You're the one, oh God,
yes,
that
Lord.
we call upon. And you're the God that answers by fire.
Yes,
For
Lord.
We're glad that you're not like Bill nor Muhammad. You're
Hallelujah.
The God that see about your people.
Yes,
now see
Lord.
About us tonight.
Thank you, Lord.
And let tonight be a miraculous night tonight.
Oh,
let
yes,
there be
Lord.
Signs and wonders that
signs
follow.
And wonders,
Give
Lord.
Us the lips of the learned tonight.
Yes, Jesus.
And let us teach with influence tonight. And let this influence spread abroad.
Yes,
and
Jesus.
Lord, y'all will coast in our territories
yes,
tonight
yes,
for
Lord.
Your glory.
For your
in
glory.
Jesus' name,
Hallelujah.
In Jesus' name,
in Jesus
we pray.
Name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. If you agree Amen. With us, can you put some hearts on the screen?
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
If you agree
Thank
with
you
us,
Lord.
Can you put some hearts on the screen?
Oh,
Amen.
Yes.
Tonight
Hallelujah.
We are so excited again
yes,
to have
we
you. We are extremely excited to have you.
Yes.
We do not take it for granted. When you come and allow us, come and join us and allow us to come into your space, we don't take it for granted. So we are excited and
yes.
we love you and we're glad that you came. Last week we had people all the way from Liberia, I believe it was,
yes.
Germany, Liberia,
Amen.
Different countries
Hallelujah.
That were watching last night. And we
yes.
were so excited to
Amen.
Have them. Amen. Perhaps
Hallelujah.
Tonight you're from a different place. If you're new, just put this is my first time, but don't go anywhere. Don't go anywhere. Don't allow any distractions to happen. Take
Amen.
Authority in your atmosphere, and let's get this word tonight.
Yes.
Amen?
Amen.
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 Let's go
Hallelujah.
To our foundation scripture tonight,
yes.
Hebrews 11 and 1.
Yes.
That's our foundation scripture. We won't stay there alone because we want to go some places tonight.
Amen.
Amen. Get ready.
Yes.
Get ready, get ready,
Hallelujah.
Get ready. Amen.
Amen.
I feel like somebody already has some testimonies.
That's
I wish
right.
we was able to just talk to each
yes.
other right now because
Amen.
I feel like some people already have
That's right.
some testimonies. In fact, if you had some testimony that have come up, amen, where you work your faith, just slide it in the comment section. We
yes.
want to celebrate with you.
Amen.
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 But now faith is
now.
The substance
yes.
of things hoped for.
Yes.
The evidence of things not seen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Amen.
Now faith is the substance. It's the matter. It's
That's
the
right.
it's the little molecules.
Come on.
It's the little things.
Yes.
And I say that it's now faith in this present tense faith. When you have faith is a thing that holds the place
mm-hmm.
for what you're believing for
right.
until what you're believing for shows up.
That's right.
So when I have faith holds the place
yes.
of what I'm believing for.
That's right.
Until what I'm believing for shows up.
Amen.
I just want to make sure that I catch everybody up before we go
yes.
into something new.
That's right.
We talked about that. We talked about now faith.
Now. Mm-hmm.
What we're saying is it is present tense.
Right.
It's not then faith. It's not soon to be faith.
Mm-hmm.
It must be now faith.
Now faith.
Mark 11.
Yes.
Around about the 22nd, 23rd verse. 23rd verse it says have the godlike kind of faith.
The God kind of faith. Amen.
Have the godlike kind
mm-hmm.
of faith.
Amen.
And you can say unto this mountain. Have the God-like kind of faith
yes.
and say unto this mountain. You can speak to the mountain when you have the right kind of faith.
That's it. Amen.
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 And so we talked about that.
Yes.
We talked about having the right kind of faith that
mm-hmm.
you can speak to the mountain. And you can say to this mountain, go here and it'll respond to you.
That's right.
Amen. And so when we're talking about faith tonight, we're talking about this ability, this supernatural thing, it is not tied to your tangible ability to be able to feel.
Come on.
It has nothing to do with feelings. Because you can feel faithful. You can feel powerful. I don't know about you, but
right.
You know, you can feel.
Come on.
You know, you can leave a service and you can be so excited. Mm-hmm. I mean, like, I'm like, woo, the pastor gave me a word. I'm really excited. But you can run into a flat tire.
All right. Come on.
You know, you're like, okay, I got a flat tire. Well, you get the tire fixed. Then before you can get to where you're going, all of a sudden, something else happens to your car, and now your car won't start.
All right.
You know, it can be having one of those days, and all of a sudden what happens is your feelings shift.
All right.
You're not as excited anymore.
Uh-huh. Right.
You're not as motivated anymore.
Amen.
You're not as energetic anymore.
Come on.
But guess what? That doesn't change your faith.
That's it. That's right.
What changes your faith is your words.
That's it. That's
your words change your faith.
Amen.
Amen.
And you know, Pastor Blessing, when you were saying about you can come and you can have a flat tire, and the flat tire will, if you're not careful, it will change your whole demeanor. You know,
Amen.
You'll be like, well, what's going on? Why did I get a? Who gonna help me? You can just go through all kind of scenarios, but tonight we letting you know that faith, when your faith is it have a context to it. You know,
oh, glory to God. Say that again.
Faith have contents to it. You know, it have value. It becomes your value. The contents is when we just left church.
Talk.
And you taught faith that faith without works is dead, and we're not moved by what we see. We're not moved by what we feel. So we have the contents, oh, God, that
glory.
Faith. Works every time. So we're not moved by the flat tire, because the context, what we got from the word of God that day was, don't be moved by what you see. Don't be moved by what you feel.
Glory to God.
Only be moved by the word of God. So look at the word of God said that he will send us a very present help in the time of trouble.
So we
just have to reach back on that.
Amen. You preaching good right
now. Hallelujah.
And you know what that reminds me of? The three little pigs.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I think one had straw, one had sticks or something. I can't remember. And one had brick.
Mm-hmm.
But you notice the three little pigs, the one who had bricks, he was cool as a cucumber.
That's right.
He never wavered to the threat of the enemy or when the wolf come.
That's right.
He saw one house blow down.
Mm-hmm.
He saw one house burn down.
All right.
But he never wavered.
Amen.
He see the success of the enemy in other people's lives.
Mm-hmm.
The other two pigs.
Yes.
He saw the enemy, the wolf. I say the enemy, but the wolf. He saw the wolf be successful in destroying two houses.
Mm-hmm.
If I remember the story correctly, it's been a long time. I was in elementary school,
right.
Balfour Elementary, Tumblesville, Georgia. And that's where I was, and I believe I first introduced. I was in a play in the Three Little Pigs in a play at Balfour Elementary School. If I remember correctly, the two pigs had to run to the last pig. You know, first pig ran to the second pig house. They blow down, they ran, mm-hmm. and all two of them ran to the third pig with the brick. Mm-hmm. So he's sitting in the brick home. He's not confused about what he's built his house with.
All right.
You get what I'm going.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
You get where I'm going. He wasn't confused at all about where he built his house or how he built his house.
Right.
He knew his house could
mm-hmm.
withstand whatever the wolf would bring him.
Amen.
Even though he's seen the other two people fail,
mm-hmm.
he knew the difference was the content of what he built with.
That's it.
I want to tell somebody, when you know that the content that you have is faith,
mm-hmm.
then you can rest assured that God will answer a faith call every single time.
Every time.
And it's
every
not,
time.
It doesn't matter what happened
right.
down the road. You know, it doesn't matter what happened to Shaniqua.
That's
it doesn't
right.
matter what happened to Ray Ray, Barbara, or Pookie.
Mm-hmm.
Because you built yours right.
That's it.
And when you build it right, you
Amen.
Rest assured.
That's it. That's it.
Nobody said the wolf
Hallelujah.
Wouldn't come blow.
All right.
He just can't blow your faith away.
That's it.
In fact, you know what? Let's go to Hebrews 10. I think it is. Is it Hebrews 10? Hebrews 10:35. Hebrews 10:35.
Hallelujah.
Let me show you what I'm talking about with confidence.
Amen.
Watch this now. Get this now. You have to keep your confidence.
Right. Amen.
You have to keep your confidence.
That's right.
And I said last week, and I think it's worth sharing again, because this is the trick of the enemy. He'll shoot what is called a fiery dart.
Mm-hmm.
He'll tell you, oh, you're not going to make it.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Oh, you're not going to pass that test.
Yeah. That's what he said.
Oh, you won't pass that exam.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, you run into somebody and say, oh, that exam was so hard. I failed it. I failed it 2 times before I passed it.
My Lord Jesus.
You'll run into that.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
But you can't let that become, you know, the foundation of truth.
Right.
That's a dart. Mm-hmm. The Bible says what? That we should put on the whole armor of God.
The whole armor. That's right.
To withstand the fiery darts of the wicked.
Amen.
He throws darts at you, but those darts he throws at you, that's not your confidence. That's not your faith. That's a dart.
That's right.
It hit you.
Mm-hmm.
The Bible says what? Pull that thing down.
That's right.
It says to pull that thing down.
Amen.
Well, I don't know if I'm going to get the job. Pull that thing down.
Pull it down.
Well, the doctor says it's not looking good. Pull that thing
Amen.
Down.
Amen.
Well, they're laying people off today. Well, pull that thing down.
Amen.
Even if they call you to the office, pull that thing down.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Pull it down.
That's right. That's what
pull it down, because you have to keep your confidence. Your confidence is not in your job.
Amen.
Your confidence is not in how you feel.
Amen.
Your confidence must remain like the third pig on what you build hope on.
That's right.
And your hope must be built in faith.
Amen.
Because faith has the substance.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
But watch what it says. It says, cast not away. This is Hebrews 10:35. Somebody put that in there for me. Hebrews 10:35 says, cast not away, therefore, your confidence.
Lord Jesus.
My goodness. Oh, my God. You know, that feels good. That's good. That's some good stuff right there. That's some good stuff right there. Because you know what I just found out? I just got revelation.
Come on.
You know what the revelation is? He says, cast not away.
Cast not away.
Now, when I read that, I don't just see cast not away. I go a little further.
Come on.
What I see is, when he says cast not away, what I don't see is what I'm celebrating.
All right.
And what I don't see is where he says, don't let him take your confidence.
All right.
That's not what the Bible says. The Bible says cast not away, which means that's effort from me.
All right. That's right.
I have to cast. The enemy can't take my confidence with his strategies. The Bible says, don't you cast it away.
Don't cast it away.
He can't take it.
So apparently somewhere down the line, I had some confidence. I had some confidence somewhere in order for him to say, cast not away, therefore your confidence. Now look, why? Because what I was saying about faith and the content, Lord have mercy, the content is the revelation that we got from God. Oh God, the revelation that we got from God is our content. So we know that God is going to answer our prayers. God is going to go before us and make every crooked place straight. Why? Because the contents of our faith, it's not built on what we say, but it's built on what the words say. Ooh. And then he done told us, cast not away thy confidence. Oh, God.
He said, don't throw away your confidence.
Don't throw it away.
The enemy can't take it. He said, if you lose it, you throw it away.
Lord have mercy.
Because the enemy can't take it, you threw it away.
Amen. Amen. Jesus.
He don't have the power to take it.
That's right.
He only gives you options.
Mm-hmm.
I'm writing last night. My wife was looking. She called me on the cell phone last night. Where are you? I said, I'm in here. I was in there working on the book. And so I wrote in there about Zach. I used the name Zach.
Mm-hmm.
Here goes Zach. Zach wake up in the morning time. Zach is so excited. He has an interview, you know, and he's getting ready to be promoted.
Mm-hmm.
And so he bought this nice outfit that he knows is just going to wow the people when he go in the boardroom, you know, with this outfit on. And I was just trying to show an analogy of how confidence can be snatched away from us.
Right.
And so I use the name Zach, don't know why, guess because I had a friend named Zach.
All right.
But I use Zach. I used him, and I said, Zach wakes up early in the morning. He's super excited. He already had ordered his attire. He was ready. You know, he jumps up, he gets dressed, and he's excited about it. But on his way out, someone questions his outfit. What do you have on, and where in the world are you going? So he said, well, I'm going to my interview. So he's still confident. So he gets out, get ready to go to the car, get in the car. All of a sudden, here goes his neighbor. Hey, Zach, what you got? What do you have on? Where in the world are you going with that? Ha, 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 ha. And so Zach like, oh, I am not worried about it. But then while he's driving to the interview, you know, he's wrestling with this dart in his mind. This dart in his mind, he's wrestling with it. Okay, he gets to the place of the interview, and the doorman opens the door for him and say, man, what in the world you have on?
Lord, I hope
you're not going to the interview with that. Now, Zach goes on to the interview, but guess what? When he get in there, he's now feeling a little bit self-conscious.
Mm-hmm.
Now he's starting to question what he have on.
Right.
When he purchased it, he felt in his heart that it was the right attire.
Amen.
Now, because three people have said something negative or contrary to what he felt or believed, he's now sitting in there and he's kind of lost his confidence. And when you lose your confidence, this is why you can't have the reward, because it's hard to focus without your confidence.
That's right. That's
you don't have your swag without your confidence.
Amen.
And so you become, it changes your posture.
Right.
You move from being superior to now inferior, because now you're unsure.
All right.
But all it was fiery darts. Mm-hmm. Here's what Zach should have done. Here's what Zach should have done. The first person said it. Here's what we do. Here's what the Bible says we should do. When he throws that first dart, hey, what do you have on? I have on the perfect outfit that I prayed about, and God showed me, and this is one. Go to the next person. Hey, what do you have on? I have on the perfect outfit. I prayed about it, and God told me. Got to the doorman. This is the perfect outfit. I'm walking right in, and I'm going to get the job. You have to constantly replace it
with
whatever the enemy says. You got to give yourself something back positive.
Amen. That's good.
If not, they will help you shape your confidence. In fact, they'll just ooze easy right out of your hand and leave you without any confidence. And the Bible says if you don't have confidence, you can't get recompense of reward.
Amen.
You can't get your reward.
Amen. And you know, when you was talking about the character Zach, he put on his outfit and he was going for an interview. So he was using his faith now. So our faith have to have a valid option, you know, a valid point where this is the job that I want to go get.
Right.
So my faith is already working before I left home. The object is the job.
Right.
So faith got something to work with.
Exactly. in the book, I said that he was already ready for the celebration. Mm-hmm. So he was already visually seeing himself with the job. And guess what the enemy did? Because that's what I was trying to get them to see. Show Zach an option that was negative. Here's what happens when you're walking in faith. The enemy wants to show you an option that's negative or contrary to what you're believing for. He wants to give you another picture. He wants to paint something for you to look at that's negative.
Right.
Amen. And once you fixate your mind on it, see, your eyes is the window to your soul. So now that thing will get down in your soul and you start to wrestle with whether or not you're going to, you know, you don't see it like you saw it to start with.
That's right.
Why? Because you let something into your ear gate. And when it got into your ear gate, if you didn't get that thing out of, that thing is going to catch root. And when it catch root, it's going to spring up and give you a harvest.
Amen. Amen.
Called doubt.
Hallelujah.
And unbelief.
That's it.
And before you know it, now you're changing your talk.
So we don't want doubt and unbelief to be working for us. We want faith to be working. And when you give faith an object to work with, the revelation that comes with that, we know that God is going to hear us. Why? Because we're walking by faith. And we're saying everything according to his word, according to his will. We're not just out there just, you know, don't know what we're going to do. So what you were saying about Zach, we got to make sure that whatever we do, that we can't be distracted. We can't cast away our confidence.
Exactly.
Amen.
And it's so easy.
Mm-hmm.
And see, if you stay in the word, it's easy. Because here's what you have to do. Every time you see or hear something contrary or negative, you go back to the faith manual and you read what it says about you or concerning your situation.
That's right.
Right?
Amen.
If you were, perfect example, if you're believing God for a house, right? Somebody believing God for a house.
Yes.
And
that's an object.
That's an object.
Okay.
Now, What you need is faith.
That's it.
Mm-hmm. Faith comes by hearing by the word of God.
Amen.
So you want to put your hope in God.
Mm-hmm.
And so what you want to do is go find something or somewhere where God has said he'll give a house.
All right. That's
and so
right.
There's in Deuteronomy, it says that God give house, he'll give you the gates of your enemies. Mm-hmm. He'll give you houses you didn't build.
That's right.
Vineyards you didn't grow.
Amen.
And so when you go and find that particular scripture, mm-hmm. that's your faith.
That's it. That's it.
Now, not your bank account.
Mm-mm. Amen.
Not your credit score.
Right.
And see, those things matter.
Mm-hmm.
They matter now. They do.
Amen.
But faith has such a powerful reaction and mm-hmm. recompense when it is done right.
That's it. Amen.
That even if you couldn't purchase the house,
mm-hmm.
you could run from a bank. Somebody could literally finance the rent to own.
That's right.
You get what I'm saying?
Right.
That God has so mm-hmm. many different ways he can bring his word
That's
to pass.
Right.
That's why you got to go back and you got to stay right there with the word.
Mm-hmm.
And every time you get shaky in your faith, you go back and read. What did God say?
That's it.
Well, what did God say?
Uh-huh.
And that's how I keep my confidence.
Mm-hmm.
What did God say?
That's right.
Because my confidence is not in how I feel.
Amen.
It's That's not right. in what they say.
That's right.
What did God's word say?
And you know, Pastor Blessed, that's why he told us that we got to fight the good fight of faith.
Every
you know,
day.
And when you were saying about your confidence, you can, it might not look like it's going to happen, but you got to fight to stay in faith.
So I can't, God, say that again.
So you got to fight to stay in faith.
Somebody put fight to stay in faith.
Amen. You got to, he said, fight the good fight of faith. So when I say that, even when I go to the bank or go, you know, to find a job, that's my object. And I might be turned down the first time, but I still got to fight the good fight of faith. I still got to say, God, your word said, now you said that if I decree a thing, that it shall be established unto me. I got to fight it every day until I see it happen, until it come to pass. Amen.
And a lot of times, what God will do is, he don't always give us something easy right away.
That's right.
God
Amen.
Sometimes, especially when God is trying to develop you and grow you. Let me go ahead and tell you this.
Yeah.
When God is trying to grow and develop you for
yes.
something bigger, and
mm-hmm.
a lot of times it's not even what you are believing, you know, for at the moment.
Right.
It's God always looks into your future.
Amen.
And so sometimes when God looks into your future and he sees where your faith account is at,
yes,
he has to build it.
All right.
And so sometimes God will put you in a position where you have to keep going back to the word.
That's right.
And you have to fight.
Mm-hmm. That's
and see,
right.
It's kind of like, you know, a boxer.
Yes.
I love Floyd Mayweather, Roy Jones Jr., and a lot of other, Pernell Whitaker,
right.
and a lot of other boxers. Mike Tyson for sure. But none of them started out at championship level. They started out amateurs.
All right.
And they had to fight in amateur level.
Yeah.
Then they had to fight and come up a little bit. And so when they was fighting, they didn't start out. When they went pro, they didn't start fighting champions.
That's right.
Why? Because if you put somebody who's just starting out in the ring with somebody who's been fighting mm-hmm. 20 fights, and you just fighting your first professional fight,
mm-hmm.
they've polished themselves.
That's right.
They've gotten skills
yes.
that you don't have yet.
Right. Amen.
I don't care how quick you are.
That's right.
You still have to have skill and stamina.
That's it.
You don't start with 15-round mm-hmm. fights. They starting with just 4 or 5 rounds.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
Amen.
Because they're building the fighter up. And so what God does sometimes is, don't get discouraged, because God builds his fighters.
Yes, that's good.
He builds his
yes.
fighters. God
Amen.
Builds somebody like me. See,
yes.
I never knew Empowerment Center.
All right.
My thought was that I was pushing my dad as far as he could go.
Mm-hmm.
Until he tell me one day he didn't want to do it no more, and then I just take over from there and run.
Right.
I never thought that I would be where I am today.
Amen.
That was never a part of my mind or my imagination.
Right.
I thought I would be serving and helping.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, when I transitioned from serving and helping to being in the front, I really didn't want to be in the front, because serving and helping behind the scenes was a whole lot less pressure.
Mm-hmm.
But a lot of what I had to endure
right.
as far as, you know, overcoming, even when he was in the earth,
mm-hmm.
I had a lot of challenges. I mean, we had to overcome a lot of obstacles when I first got married. You know, a lot of those things was frustrating, but for us, but It built our faith. Mm-hmm. It was teaching us. And it's like every time he would, every time my dad would teach a message, it looked like God would send me into the ring to fight the thing he was talking about. He taught a message one time, and you appreciate this, I'm telling you, this is God and it's true. My wife could tell you. My dad had just preached a message called Let It Be. Yeah. I don't know if somebody watching, if they remember. I don't know, Mom, if you remember this. But he preached a message called Let It Be.
Let It Be.
Let It Be. He was talking about let it be because I think it came from Genesis where God said, mm-hmm. let there be. And I think he took that and let it be. So it was a hot summer day. And me and my wife had this rodeo. It was her rodeo truck. And so the air conditioner went out in it.
All right.
And so
on.
I'm sitting in the truck. It's after church over and everything. And we getting ready to leave. And my wife said, she said, and you know, I told this story before, but there's some people hadn't heard it. Let me tell it to them.
Amen.
So here's what my wife said. We sitting in the truck, getting ready to go home. And my wife said, I wish we could ride with Ella Bussey. You know, they didn't call him Elder Bus or Pastor, but they called him Ella Bussey.
Yeah.
You know, and so she said, I wish we could ride with Ella Bussey.
Oh, because she was hot.
She was hot. That car was hot. We were sweating in that truck. That truck was hot.
Oh,
and
Jesus.
So I thought about that thing. And then the message came back to me, you know, that let it be.
Mm-hmm.
And I said to myself, you know what? I had that message kept coming back, let it be. I draw my hand back. I said, I hit that bottom of that dashboard. I said, boom, let it be in the name of Jesus. The air didn't say,
all right.
I looked at my wife, not who you want to ride with. Because, I mean, the power of God had worked. But it was moments like that.
That's
it was
right.
During those early years when we had to exercise our faith that taught me how to become stronger.
All right.
Now, every level, I don't care where you go to, as long as you live, there'll always be a challenge.
Amen.
That you have to, that God constantly grow your faith because
that's
this is ever increasing.
That's it.
It will never stop. You never come to a place in your life unless you become complacent and you don't want to grow anymore.
Amen.
And if you don't want to grow anymore, shame on you. But as long as you're trying to grow, God will always give you a fight.
Amen.
That will grow your faith.
Amen. I just want to add, too, when you were saying about when your father was living, and how you helped him in the ministry, and how you thought that, I mean, it was just going to be you helping him, and, you know, one day you might take over his ministry. But faith have a purpose.
Right, right.
Faith have a purpose.
It does.
You know, when God told Abraham, I'm going to make you the father of many nations, Abraham had to go through because faith had a purpose for God to take him to where he needed to be. So you had faith had a purpose for your life, for you to be the pastor of the Empowerment Center. It's a purpose.
It was a purpose.
Faith have a purpose.
Faith has a purpose,
amen.
Absolutely. And
amen.
You know what? I was just thinking about something because the Bible says that even if we believe not, God yet abideth faithful.
Mm-hmm.
Because God cannot change his mind.
Amen.
To the point to where if God decrees something, it becomes law.
That's right.
And it has to come to pass.
That's
now,
right.
We see with Hezekiah, he sends a decree for Hezekiah. He's going to tell him to get his house in order.
Mm-hmm.
And then Hezekiah cries out unto the Lord, and God turns the prophet around to go back and then to extend Hezekiah more time.
Mm-hmm.
But the decree still came to pass.
That's
God
right.
Just extended time.
Amen.
But he didn't change it.
Right. Amen.
And so I remember one time when Prophet Brian Jefferson Mosley was preaching, you know, my dad was still in the earth at that moment, and he prophesied something to me that didn't make any sense. And so what I'm saying is that even though I didn't really grab it or believe it, and I've seen Prophet Brian Jefferson Mosley prophesy, I mean, like, really accurate. But he said to me, he said, there's going to come a day that this church will know your name, but they'll no longer know you in the same way. My daddy was living. I had no idea what he was talking about. It made no sense to me.
Right.
You know, it really didn't. And so I didn't think much of it. It's kind of like you just let it roll right off your back, like water off a duck back and left on out of there. And then he goes on and he says something else. He says, and God's going to give you this city. He said, God's going to give you the prostitutes. God's going to give you the drug addicts. God's going to give you all of those people. He says, those are the people God's going to give you. He says, God has given you the city.
All right.
This is what he said to me years ago. And then I'm like, okay, yeah, that sounds good. Mm-hmm. You know, young man, it sounded really good to me. But then he says to me, he said, he already gave you Larry. And that was my partner, but my best friend. See, at the time I had won him to the Lord, mm-hmm. and he was standing right there.
All right.
Now, all of that was exciting, but I didn't grab the word to the point where I hit it in my heart and just like really pondered on it.
Amen.
But years later, the same word that God released, he brought to pass.
Yes. Hallelujah.
And we have people who come to the ministry, little hair and needles in their arms.
Amen.
No, never thought I'd be pastor.
Amen.
But it happened. And my point being, and what I want to tell the people tonight, that whenever God releases a word,
yes, that's right.
That word is law.
Yes.
That's why you can't go off of your feelings. You got to go off of his word, because
right.
his word won't change. Mm-hmm. His word, there's nothing that can turn or alter his word.
That's right. Amen.
So you ride on God's word, mm-hmm. no matter how you feel.
That's right. Amen.
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 But I want to go somewhere before we close out. How much time we have? I want to go, take me to, I want to go to John. Was it John 11? Oh, I want to go to John. I think it was John 11. Let's see. Take me to John 11, 34. That might be where I wanted to go. I should have wrote it down when I was meditating. Yeah, I guess that'll work. Ah, it says, and said, where have you laid him? They All said right. unto him, Lord, come and see.
Come
I think
see.
I'm in the right place. Let me see. Let's move on to the next one. Jesus wept. Oh, we're getting there. Then said the Jews, behold, how he loved him. And some of them said, could not this man which opened the eyes of the blind have caused that even this man should not have died? We getting there. Mm-hmm. Jesus, therefore, again, groaning in himself, coming to the grave. Yeah, that's where we're getting at. It was a cave and a stone lay upon it. Jesus said, take ye away the stone. Martha, the sister of him that was dead, saith unto him, Lord, by this time he stinketh.
Come on.
For he had been dead for 4 days. Hold right there. Don't go nowhere. Hold. Go back right there. Watch this, y'all. Listen to me now. Listen to what I was just telling you earlier. How about Zach? How sometimes something comes to try to give you a different picture.
Mm-hmm.
Now, here comes the resurrected.
All right. Come on.
Here comes the water walker.
Yes.
Here comes the one who we call Mary's baby.
Come on.
Here's the man who goes to the pool of Bethesda,
Hallelujah.
Who sees a man who's been sick for 38 long years and mm-hmm. said, will thou be made whole, and heal the man when the man could never make it to the pool. Here's the one that on his way to Jairus' house to heal Jairus' daughter,
mm-hmm.
heals the woman who's been sick for 12 long years with an issue of blood. This man is the same man that healed blind Bartimaeus. He's
All
the
right.
man who commands the storm.
Yes.
He's the man who can
Hallelujah.
Send the disciples to the other side and then walk on water in the middle of
mm-hmm.
the storm
Hallelujah.
And then give man authority to walk on water, and he shows up.
Mm-hmm. Come on.
And they tell the man,
yes,
who was in the beginning,
thank you,
of the beginning, when there was a beginning, mm-hmm. before there was a beginning.
Hallelujah.
He says to the man, or she says to the man, by this time he's stinking.
Uh-huh.
But Jesus had already said he's not dead.
All right.
He's asleep.
Yes.
They want to give him a picture of death.
All right.
And try to change or alter mm. Jesus' picture of sleep.
Come on.
The enemy always want to alter whatever God is saying, whatever you're believing. He wants to show you something different.
All right.
Mm-hmm. He wants you to have options.
Yes.
Tell him you don't need any more options.
All right.
The word of the Lord settles it. You don't need That's another it. Option.
No more
you
options.
Don't need, God doesn't need an option.
Hallelujah. Amen.
You don't need an option. Look what Jesus says now. I mean, look what she says. She says unto him, by this time, he stinketh.
My Lord.
Mm-hmm. For he's been dead 4 days.
4 days.
So she wants Jesus to understand. Now you're trying to roll this man up.
All right.
This man been dead for 4 days.
4 days.
And he's stinking. Mm-hmm. So now think about this. Now trying to give Jesus an image.
Come on.
Trying to give Jesus another picture that
yes.
this man.
Yes.
You know, that he thinks is sleeping.
Mm-hmm.
That he believes is sleeping.
All right. Come on.
Is dead.
Mm-hmm.
And not only dead. She gives him a time.
All right.
Four days.
Uh-huh.
You've been trying to wake up somebody 4 days. By this time, the bugs,
That's
the
right.
maggots,
mm-hmm.
the bullfly, everything has been eating his flesh.
That's right.
But watch what Jesus says in the next verse. And see how this thing plays out. Jesus said unto her, said I unto thee, that if thou wouldest believe, thou shouldest see the glory of God. He says to her,
come on.
I told you before that if you can believe, you can see glory. If you can believe, you can see glory. If you can believe, you can see the glory of God.
Amen.
If you can believe, you can see God's glory. I want to tell somebody, my God, I feel my help.
Yes.
If you can believe, you can see God's glory. The enemy always want to show you something different. He always want to show you the opposite of what God is saying. But if you can believe the word of the Lord, you
only
can see God's glory.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Jesus, I'm not moved by how long you've been dead. I am the resurrection.
That's it.
I'm the water walker.
Yes.
Let's look at where his confidence rests at. Then they took away the stone. They went on and did it anyway. From the place where the dead was laid.
All right.
And Jesus lifted up his eyes and said, Father, I thank thee that thou hast heard me. He hadn't even said a word.
All right. Come on.
My God, good God of Zion. He hadn't even said a word, but look at the power of his confidence.
That's it. His
he had not said a word, but he already know God has heard him.
That's it. Hallelujah.
Why? Because his ears are not too dull of his hearing. His ears are not too dull that he cannot hear.
Amen.
Oh my goodness.
Come on. That's good teaching. Whew. Hallelujah.
I'm about to wrap it up.
Thank you, Lord.
Oh my.
Yes.
My wife said I better slow down. And I knew that thou hearest me always.
Always. Uh-oh.
Jesus says never a moment when God is not listening.
That's right. Always.
My goodness.
Oh, God.
Whoo, Jesus said there's never a moment when God is not listening to the request of men.
Amen.
He listened to his children.
That's right. Yes, indeed.
But because of the people which stand by, I said it, that they may believe that thou hast sent me. Jesus said, I don't even have to call Lazarus.
That's right.
Me showing up will make Lazarus get up. He says, but because of the unbelievers, I'm about to show them the power of God's glory.
That's it.
Friends, God want to use your faith to show the world his glory exists in the earth.
That's right.
God want to show somebody his glory. But notice now, he says, his relationship with God, he understands. And see, when you understand who God is, then you don't waver.
That's right.
And the reason why a lot of people waver is because they don't know the Abba Father.
That's it.
And what he comes to do.
Amen.
Don't ever pray for me if I'm sick and you say, if it be the Lord's will.
All right.
If I have enough strength and you standing over me and I'm asking you to pray for me and I'm not feeling good and you say, if it be the Lord's will, I pray to God I have enough strength, I can grab something and well you cross your noggin. Because if you don't know God's will concerning his healing for his people.
That's right, Pastor.
You don't need to be praying for nobody. Because the Bible says in Isaiah, by his stripes you're healed. He didn't take them stripes for nothing.
He sure didn't. Amen.
But my point being, and I have to be careful. You know, people got all worked up. Don't get worked up.
Amen.
I'm just talking.
It's only because we know the covenant. We know the word.
The covenant.
Amen. That's it.
Amen. The covenant.
That's it. Hallelujah.
When you know the covenant.
That's it. That's right.
People call you arrogant, but you're not arrogant. You're confident in who he is.
That's it.
He's never dropped his word. He's never dropped a promise. He never failed at keeping his promise to me.
Amen. That's right.
I pray for my children. I watch my children get healed. I pray for other people and I watch God heal other people.
That's right.
I watch other people give testimonies of how God has delivered them and how God has done great things for them. And I've never seen God come up short.
All right.
And so it's hard for me not to have confidence in someone who's been perfect with me.
Amen. That's right.
So when I'm praying, I don't pray in a mist or wavering when I know that he wished me well.
Amen.
And when people don't know how much God loves them.
Hallelujah.
And that's right. The danger of religion and tradition. Mm-hmm. Because religion and tradition, and I'm not throwing off, hey, look, have all that you want. I don't want any. Religion and tradition teaches rules and regulations. Nothing wrong with rules and regulations, but rules and regulations can't dominate love.
All right. That's right.
Because Amen. God so loved the world.
Amen.
That he gave. And the power of love means that this is what love does for me. When I learned God from the standpoint of love rather than rules and regulations, mm-hmm. I found out with rules and regulations that at some point I'm going to fail. You know, whether somebody mm-hmm. cut me off in traffic or I get angry or something to that nature. You know, we as humans, sometimes we fail.
All right.
You know, mm-hmm. sometimes you fail.
That's right.
And sometimes you fail. And we're not talking about nothing big or major. We're just talking about, you know, sometimes you and your wife you have an argument.
That's right.
Sometimes Amen. You and your neighbor might have some, mm-hmm. you know, some problems. Somebody, something on the job may right. come up.
Yeah.
And then you have to go back and apologize.
That's the truth.
Now, if you had to be perfect, you're not going to make it.
That's right.
And so rules and regulations try to teach you, when you're talking about religion and tradition, it teaches you about the rules and regulations, mm-hmm. the rules and regulations. And then you find out when you're not perfect, you know, and then you find yourself keep failing, it becomes frustrating.
Right.
But here's what love teaches you. Love teaches you that no matter what state of mind you're in, you can come into the presence of God for restoration.
Mm-hmm.
He restores.
Amen.
You know, mm-hmm. his desire is to restore you.
Amen.
You know, his desire is to reposition
yes.
you.
Yes.
And so that's the power of knowing God in that manner, because if you know God in that manner, then when you know you haven't done, let's say with somebody who's believing God for a house or something, but you haven't done everything right. Now, that doesn't mean you're supposed to override the rules,
mm-hmm.
the natural rules. But what I'm saying is, you still come to God.
That's right.
You still come mm-hmm. to God. And you still bring that petition to God.
Right.
Because you leave it up to God to decide what he wants to
Amen.
Do.
Amen.
You just give it to him.
Amen.
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 Glory
Amen.
To God. We got about 10 more minutes.
And I just want to say, when you was talking about, you know, about faith, and we've been talking about faith, and faith produces works. And when it produces work, it conditions us to believe God for whatever we've been believing for. Because why? Because we believe what the word of the Lord say. Amen. And so when we do that, we could be like Abraham. He said, Abraham, he didn't stagger at the promises of God,
mm-hmm.
but he believed God. He didn't waver. Whatever God had told him, it took a long time, but he still believed God. So I just want to say to somebody tonight, whatever you have been believing God for, maybe it have not manifest, you know, now, but it will manifest if you keep believing God, if you
Amen.
Keep trusting God. He said, your faith gonna produce the object that you've been believing for.
Amen.
Your faith gonna produce it. Why? Because you believe God. And why? Because you are fighting the good fight of faith. Amen.
Amen.
And your faith gonna produce works. Amen. Because when we it said faith without works is dead. So we gonna get up and we gonna use our faith. We gonna let our faith work for us, and that's gonna set our life and our lifestyle. Why? Because I'm sitting about what the words that's coming out my mouth.
Sitting about the words mm-hmm. that comes out of my
Amen.
Mouth. I use my mouth as my weapon.
Yes. Amen.
And I'm telling you that
Hallelujah.
Anytime the enemy is coming at you, use your mouth.
That's right.
But don't say what you want to say. Say what the words say.
Say what the words say.
Isn't that what Jesus
that's
did in
right.
Luke chapter 4? Mm-hmm. Jesus said what the words
Amen.
Said.
Amen.
He comes to say what the words said, mm-hmm. but Jesus could go to Lazarus.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
He can tell a woman mm-hmm. that's after she's told him about he's dead, he's stinking, he's mm-hmm. been in there 4 days. Mm-hmm. And she said, well, if I told you, if you believe, you can see the glory.
See the glory.
Same thing he told the disciples in Mark 11. He says, if you believe, you mm-hmm. can have what you say.
That's it.
Have what you believe
that's
when you
it.
Say it.
Hallelujah. Thank you,
But
Jesus.
You have to believe.
Amen.
And so tonight, that whole thing about relationship is
yes.
when you come into relationship with God and you get to know God, you start to develop a different kind of faith.
Yes.
Because he becomes more of your Abba Father than God.
Amen.
Or Lord.
Yes.
Or ruler over you. He becomes more or less like a father.
Yes.
Now you know your father in his position. You're in your father's position. Of course he's the head. Mm-hmm. But you don't feel him as a hard taskmaster. You feel him also as a protector, mm-hmm. a provider,
yes.
a comforter, a keeper. And so you want to come to the place to where you begin to develop a relationship with God in a way that you see him as an Abba Father. Mm-hmm. And then if you never had a real father in your life, or maybe a stepdad in your life, your friend had a really good father in their life. If you see that relationship, think about God, and he's so much more greater. Mm-hmm. Because that's he says, right. If a good man can, you know, if a son asks for bread, I think he says, can't give him, father wouldn't bring him a serpent or
that's
something,
right.
I believe it was.
A stone, I believe
it was. And so God is so much greater. But you want to come to know him as an Abba Father.
Yes.
Because when you start to know him and know how he operates, know how he thinks, know his heart towards you, and then when you're talking faith, you talk faith with a level of confidence because you know you're asking something within God's will.
Yes, that's right.
You know, everything you ask him is within his power.
All right.
But within his power might not be within his will concerning mm-hmm. your life.
That's
what's
right.
in God's power may not be in God's will concerning you.
That's right.
So now, it doesn't do me any good to try to believe God to go, you know, Lord, I'm believing you that I'm going to go and be an NFL star by next summer.
Right.
That I'm going to get a job in NFL. They might give me a job in NFL, but it's probably going to be at the gate somewhere. working in the locker room cleaning up, but it won't be on the football field running a football.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying?
Amen.
Catching one, throwing one, or blocking for mm-hmm. one. Why? Because I don't have the skill set for it.
Right.
And that's I'm good. Sure that's not God's will concerning mm-hmm. it. He would have conditioned me
that's right.
for
Amen.
That.
Amen.
And so now when I'm believing God for something, I'm believing for something within God's will.
Yes.
Concerning my mm-hmm. life. And now how do I know that? I got to know myself too.
That's
I need
it.
To know my gifts. I need to know my talents. I need to know what God has invested in me. Because
mm-hmm.
whatever God has invested in you, God is looking for a return from it.
Yes.
He didn't just
that's
invest
right.
it and leave it.
All right.
He's watching over mm-hmm. it to get a return.
That's it.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Glory to God.
That's
so
good.
Habakkuk 2:4 says, the just shall live by faith.
Yes.
This is a lifestyle.
Yes, it is.
Faith is a lifestyle.
Mm-hmm.
Faith is a lifestyle. I pray we said something tonight and that has blessed your heart.
Hallelujah.
I pray that we said something tonight that has challenged you to look at faith different, look
Amen.
At life different. Do yourself service by going back and watching this program again. Because you need to get it over and over and over and over again.
Amen.
Until you really get the concept of faith.
Yes.
And when you get the concept of faith, you're unstoppable.
Yes.
Why? Hallelujah. Because faith is unstoppable.
Amen.
Amen. You can't go to sleep on faith. It keeps moving.
Amen. That's right.
Glory to God.
Keep moving.
Listen, we want to offer Christ to you tonight. And you want to do that?
Amen.
You want to offer somebody Christ
tonight? Yes, amen. And I believe that we're going to have a lot of people that's going to accept Christ as their personal Savior tonight. Why? Because you are hearing the word of God. And the Bible said, out of all your getting, get some
understanding.
And I believe tonight that you have had some understanding of this word called faith. Amen. You don't have to just wonder out there. Amen. Now you know you can attain it. You can obtain faith. You know that faith have a purpose and faith produce objects. Amen. So tonight, I just want to encourage you and lead you to the Lord. Amen. Amen. I want you to just repeat after me. Father.
Father.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
I thank you tonight.
Tonight I thank you.
What I have heard.
For what I've heard.
And I thank you for your word.
And I thank you for your word.
And I thank you for understanding.
I thank you for understanding tonight.
I ask you, Lord. To come into my life.
To come into my life.
Forgive me.
Forgive me.
For all of my sins.
For all of my sins.
Creating me. A clean heart.
A clean heart.
And renew. A right spirit.
A right spirit.
Within me.
Within me.
And I believe tonight.
I confess
with my mouth. mouth.
I confess with my
and
mouth.
And I believe in my heart.
And I believe in my heart.
That Jesus died on the cross.
That Jesus died on the cross.
And I am saved.
And I am saved.
I am born again.
I am born again.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Listen, if you're born again, if you accepted Christ tonight, yes. If you would put born again in there, we would love to celebrate
yes.
with you. We
Amen.
Are. We would love to celebrate with you
yes,
tonight
Lord.
If you're
Thank
born
you,
again.
Jesus.
Amen. Don't hesitate. Share Hallelujah. With us tonight. We want to celebrate with you.
Amen.
And before we go, we want to all make an offertory appeal unto you tonight. Amen.
Amen.
We're going to need, for those that are listening by way of radio and for those who are watching by way of YouTube, amen, Facebook, here's some simple steps to giving.
Yes.
And the Bible says we should never enter the courts without an offering. Amen. We know you're not. In our physical building, but any seed of offering that you can share with us tonight will be greatly appreciated.
Amen.
Amen. It Hallelujah. Is always used wisely.
Thank you.
Amen.
Jesus.
We are very we believe in excellence. Amen. We believe in integrity.
Amen.
Amen. But here's how you give. Yes. Cash App, one of the easiest ways, Cash App, $ECIM. $ECIM.
Yes.
That's Cash App, $ECIM. You can text to give. Is the text to give still the same? We good with that? Text to give is, go by what I'm telling you. We're making some changes. It's 888-364-GIVE.
Amen.
That's 888-364-GIVE. That give is 4483. That's 888-364-4483.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So any seed tonight, amen, will be greatly appreciated. And we give God praise. We definitely want to pray over that seed. While
amen.
We're praying over that seed, can you go ahead and let us know what city you're from? Amen. So we can make sure we're praying with you. And we also want to offer partnership unto you tonight. If you desire,
yeah.
if you're somewhere and you're saying, you know what, I love the ministry, I love what you're doing. Hey, we definitely would love you to like to be a partner with us. So just put partnership in the comment
Amen.
And someone will reach out to you. Amen. And don't forget to share.
Amen.
Father, we thank you for every seed that's given. We thank you for every seed that's been given.
Yes.
We bless your name tonight for the
Amen.
Giver of that seed.
Amen.
I believe by faith that while we're going through this season of transition, I believe
yes.
that you're doing something supernatural and incredible.
Amen.
I believe that though it look chaotic and though things may look out of order, but I believe that it is a perfect and it's a ripe time for harvest. I believe that you're in this whole thing that's going on. I believe you're involved
yes,
in it
Lord.
In a way that
Thank
you're getting ready
God.
To give strategies. You're giving plans.
Yes.
You're giving insight. You're giving divine
Thank
favor.
You,
I believe from this ash heap of despair, you're lifting men. You're lifting
Hallelujah.
Women up from the bottom, and you're taking them places that they never dreamed that they could go.
Hallelujah.
I'm praying tonight that if they sow tonight, Father, just as you've been kind unto us, be kind unto them and cause their seed to come back unto them 30, 60, and 100 fold.
Amen.
We believe in you for
Thank
the testimony that's going to come from the seed that's sown.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. They want me to give you the text number, the give number again. It is 888-364-4483.
Yes.
Put in ECIM. When you text to give that number, if you would text ECIM08. ECIM08.
Amen.
Text ECIM08 to the number 888-364-GIVE. Amen. 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 Any cities on our way out?
Hallelujah.
Amen. Any cities we want to see where we got them, where they're coming from.
Hallelujah.
North Carolina. That must
All
be
right.
that's Lamar. Okay, good to see you, Lamar.
Hey, we
see you on every week after week. Amen. We are praying for you, believing God for divine favor concerning you.
Amen.
Amen. Glory to God.
Thank you, Jesus. Glory, glory, glory.
Glory to God.
Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord. Hey, don't forget to share. It's real easy. And if you're ECIM and you're not sharing, shame on you.
Amen.
The Bible says a man don't take his own house is worse than an infidel.
Hallelujah.
Amen. If you don't believe in it, how you expect somebody else to believe in it? Amen. Share, share, share.
Share. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Glory to God. We can get a little music then.
Yeah.
Any questions you may have, anything you want to discuss next week, any questions you have from this teaching, put it in there. We'll try to address it next week.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, too.
Amen.
Glory, glory, glory.
Glory to God. Give me just a sec. Let's see what she got.
Amen.
Make sure she...
And remember, we walk by faith.
And not by sight.
Amen.
We walk by faith.
And not by sight.
And not by sight.
And your faith is working for you.
And your faith is working for you. You know, I heard a man say that you'll go take a job. And the people say they're going to pay you $15 an hour. Mm-hmm. Be to work Monday.
All right.
You'll go to work Monday. And work all week, on that man's word.
That's right.
That they're going to pay you $15 an hour.
That's right.
You hadn't seen the check.
Mm-mm.
You hadn't seen the people who write the check.
That's right.
You hadn't even seen the owner.
Amen.
We got Douglas, Georgia in the house.
Amen.
Douglasville, praise God. Thank God for Douglasville in the house.
Amen.
Amen. But he said you'll take a man at his word,
uh-huh.
And you'll go and you'll work for somebody.
Mm-hmm.
But then God gives us a word.
All right.
And we'll question every word God give us.
Help us, Lord.
But we'll go work for a man.
Amen.
And say he'll pay us $15 an hour.
And sometimes we have to work a whole month.
I'm telling you right now, if you
that's right.
I don't want one of them jobs.
That's right. Sometimes you have to work 2 weeks.
Praise God. I had them 2 weeks. I like them every week, praise God.
Oh, God.
Amen.
But our faith
glory to
working.
God. Anybody else before we get out of here? Don't forget, on our way out. Any questions, any comments, anything you want to talk to us about with faith, amen. Just put it in the comment.
Amen.
We go back and look at them. Amen. Or no, better yet, go to the message and send us a message.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
God bless you.
Yes. Your faith is working. Hallelujah.
Sunday service, 10 o'clock.
Amen.
Sunday service, 10 o'clock.
Amen.
Hey, be here. Sunday service, 10 o'clock. Amen. It's been awesome. Can't wait to see you Sunday.
Amen. Hallelujah.
We got to get out of here.
Yeah.
Don't forget to share. Leave a comment.
Amen.
Hey, how you feel?
I feel wonderful.
I'm comfortable.
My confidence is working.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Bombayar, Saranar, Arrivederci.